Hello, this is Eric at Really Right Stuff, and today I'm going to be showing you how to clean and maintain the wrist pin on your Really Right Stuff tripod. Now, if you failed the wrist pin, you know, the frozen wrist pin test that we described in the previous video, or if your wrist pin has recently become contaminated with a lot of dirt and debris, if it continually loosens, this video is going to show you how to disassemble, clean, reassemble, and essentially overall maintain the wrist pin joint of your tripod and better improve the performance and increase the longevity of your tripod. Now, some of the tools that you're gonna need to perform this cleaning and maintenance is you're gonna need a bearing grade grease. We use Superlube here. Also, you can go to just about any local auto store and get just kind of a bearing grade grease, like a single use application. These cost about $1, almost $2. This will also work. This you can pick up at just about any local hardware store. It's gonna be around $8. You're gonna need some toothpicks, a toothbrush, two different hex keys, and the size of hex key is gonna again depend on what series tripod you're using. We've got here a 3-series tripod, so we are going to be using the, let's see what these, 3/16. And then you're gonna need a dry cloth, a damp cloth, some cotton swabs or Q-tips. You'll need a cleaner, that's a non-residue leaving cleaner. We use, in this video here, we're gonna be using isopropyl alcohol or rubbing alcohol. You can also use acetone or brake cleaner, again, as long as it's a non-residue leaving cleaner. We're gonna have some just fresh water, clean water, and then a Scotch-Brite pad. Now, if your wrist pin is severely contaminated, depending on if you over-applied Loctite or if there's just been a lot of salt or salt water that's gotten in there and contaminated it, it might be harder to remove. In those cases, you might need these additional tools. We have here a heat gun or a hair dryer. This is if you use Loctite or over-apply Loctite to loosen the thread screw to begin with. We have a hard bristle brush, a long punch, and a hammer. The long punch and the hammer are gonna help you remove the wrist pin if it's frozen in there pretty securely. And then the bristle brush is only gonna be needed if your wrist pin is, once removed, severely contaminated on the outside to help clean it if the toothbrush is not enough. All right, now let's get started. Depending on how contaminated your wrist pin is, this is gonna take approximately 7 to 10 minutes to completely disassemble, clean, and then reassemble each of the 3 different wrist pins. The first step is using your appropriate size hex keys, loosen one screw from the wrist pin. If the screw is difficult to remove, possibly due to overuse of Loctite, you'll need heat to loosen the bond. Once you have one screw removed, go ahead and remove the wrist pin. If the wrist pin is difficult to remove, possibly due to overcontamination by salt water or overuse of Loctite, you may need to use the hammer and long punch. Otherwise, the wrist pin should easily slide out of the apex. Now, remove the clevis from the apex, keeping track of the washers. You want to clean the outside of the wrist pin thoroughly using a Scotch-Brite pad. If the Scotch-Brite pad isn't cleaning effectively enough, go ahead and use the hard bristle brush to remove any external debris. Now, using our cleaner, clean out the inside of the apex bore and then dry thoroughly. Remove any oxidation on the face of the washers by scrubbing them with the Scotch-Brite pad. Next, we'll disassemble the pull tab assembly. Remove the pull tab itself as well as the black insert. Checking for any external debris, thoroughly clean the top of the clevis using either a toothbrush or a damp cloth, then dry thoroughly. Clean the pull tab as well as the black pull tab insert using a toothbrush or Scotch-Brite pad. Please note that the pull tab insert has an asymmetrical groove. With the groove closest to the pull tab, reposition the black insert on the pull tab spring. With the black insert and pull tab reassembled, reposition the pull tab assembly into the clevis, keeping track of which side faces out. When aligning the pull tab on a 1-series tripod, align the pull tab on the same face as the curved portion of the clevis joint. When repositioning the pull tab on a 2-series tripod, align the face of the pull tab opposite this curved bump at the apex joint of the clevis. When aligning the pull tab on a 3-series tripod, align the face of the pull tab with the curved portion of the clevis joint. When aligning the pull tab of a 4-series tripod, position the face of the pull tab in position with the slight divot on the clevis. When positioned properly, there should be tension with the pull tab sitting flush. Using a cotton swab, apply grease to the outside of the wrist pin. evenly coating the exterior of the wrist pin. Then insert the wrist pin into the apex bore, rotating as you do so to ensure a thorough coating. Replace washers on either side of the apex and reconnect the leg clevis to the apex. Now, reinsert the wrist pin, guiding it through the clevis, washers, and apex. It may take a little finesse to align the wrist pin through both the clevis and apex bores. Once through, use a cotton swab to remove any excess grease.
Please note that we no longer recommend the use of thread locker fluid on the wrist pin of your tripod. The reason being is that misapplication can result in contamination of the wrist pin, causing a number of issues, among which is the wrist pin will freeze in place, and that results in the tripod leg section loosening over time with use.
Check that your apex screw has a usable nylon patch. These patches are good for 5 or more uses. If you do not have one, or if yours is worn out, contact Really Right Stuff for a replacement. Tighten down the apex screw to your desired tension. As a final step, check the leg angle tension to confirm user preference.
Now that you've finished cleaning, lubricating, and reassembling the wrist pin of your tripod, go ahead and repeat that process in the remaining 2 leg sections. If you still have any questions, please feel free to give us a call. This is Eric at Really Right Stuff, thanking you for watching.